The collection of fats, grease, and oils by Keysby-based Russell Reed Industrial Waste Haulers for clients such as Rutgers University dining halls helps curb the fuel costs and carbon footprint of the joint meeting Essex and Union County's wastewater treatment plant in Elizabeth. Representatives of both Russell Reed and joint meeting explain how.
They're cleaning and prepping food along this whole station, and all of the food, fat, oil, dirty water makes its way down through the sink, through all of these pipes, and then onto that main trap where all the food waste is gathering. And that's the process: food preparation, waste out through the sink, and collection into the grease trap. So another part of the process is obviously cleaning down the prepper. As you can see, they have big hoses and floor drains. And at the end of the day, they'll come in, wash the floor, wash these big vats. And again, everything makes its way down through these big floor drains, out the back, again into the grease trap where they're going to do treatment outside. And at the grease trap, that's where the real separation happens. That's what the grease trap is there for. The fat, the oil, the grease, the food particles, the garbage that makes its way down through the drain needs to be separated out before it goes to the sewer. The whole point of the grease trap is to not let stuff that can clog up the sewer make its way out. Inside of the trap, the water will flow through, the fat and oil will rise to the top, the food particles and other garbage will float to the bottom. Relatively clean water flows through the trap, out to the street and into the sewer system to make its way out for final treatment at a wastewater plant. What we do is we come and clean the trap. We take out the fat, the oil, the grease, the garbage that was contained in the trap and prevented from going out from the sewer. So our technician shows up, removes the manhole covers and lids, and sucks out the contents of the trap so that the trap itself can be maintained and does not get overwhelmed with the garbage and oil that is being caught there, so that the system operates well and that the water that makes its way out to the sewer is clean and doesn't clog up the city. The truck shows up, performs a service, he takes on his waste into the truck, and then he goes directly to the wastewater treatment plant, in this case, Joint Meeting of Essex and Union. And at Joint Meeting in Essex, he'll pull up, he'll discharge the wastewater off of his truck through a screening process, and that water will then make its way through the treatment.
We're at the Joint Meeting of Essex and Union County's Wastewater Treatment Facility in Elizabeth, New Jersey, and we are located at the effluent end of our primary settling tanks, where we receive fats, oils, and grease from various haulers, one being Russell Reed in Keysby, New Jersey. We receive our fats, oils, and grease in our scum pits. That fat, oil, and grease material is pumped to our digestion facility. The fats, oils, and grease serve as a food source for various microorganisms, which produce a gas product, one of those constituents being methane. That methane gas is used as a fuel at the Joint Meeting of Essex and Union Counties in the cogeneration process for electricity and heating. And we produce anywhere between 2.4 and 3.2 megawatts of electricity per day to augment our already purchased electricity from the power grid.